I'll tell you what, there's nothing worse than getting halfway through laminating a tiled mural piece or a full roll of printed material and developing a wrinkle, a crease, or having your material go one direction and have your lamination go the other way. With me, I have the GFP 363TH, the top heat laminator, but I want to take you through the process to recalibrate or reset the adjustment to your machine so that that lamination runs straight and true from beginning to end, full roll on lamination. If you watch all the way through the end of this video, I got two extra lamination tips and tricks that'll kind of help you out with your lamination process. So the first thing we're going to do, the reason this happens on these machines is because your two rollers go out of balance. GFP is a really nice machine. It's got these oversized rollers that create the tension and the pressure between your printed film and your lamination. A really nice feature, but it's a mechanical device and everything goes out of alignment at one point in time or another, especially if you're using your machine for lamination as well as using it to mount boards, applying transfer tape, all the different functions that a laminator are meant to be used for. Periodically checking this alignment is going to be key. So you can see from left to right over here on this side of the machine, this pinch wheel is touching over here, but on this side, I'm at about a quarter inch or a half inch gap. Now that's pretty extreme, but it doesn't take a lot of deviation from left to right to affect how lamination is going. So if you're running into issues where you're getting wrinkles or your print film starts nice and straight together, but by the time you laminate the whole roll, it starts to drift and shift apart from each other, chances are it's caused from a misalignment of that bottom and top pinch wheel. So let's go ahead and go through the process. So you need a couple Allen wrenches and a screwdriver to get this process started. First, we're going to take off the set screw for these tension adjust knobs on the drive side. Before we remove this panel, safe to say, let's go ahead and unplug our machine from the wall outlet. This way we don't run the risk of exposing ourselves to anything inside the machine. We're going to go ahead and loosen off the set screw and remove all four of these tension knobs. Okay, great. Now with our tension knobs removed, we're going to go ahead and remove the screws that are holding on the panel. Okay, great. Now with this panel removed, we can see the balancing system as well as the direct drive of the GFP rollers. So what we're going to need to do is loosen up this spur gear connection here so we can independently adjust this side of it. So a 3mm Allen will remove the set screw holding the spur gear together, and then a 5mm Allen head will allow us to pull that top spur gear away. We don't want to fully remove, or we don't need to fully remove this. We just need to disengage the spur gear mechanism to allow us to adjust the vertical alignment of this side of that top roller. So once we've done that, got everything nice and loose, let's go ahead and make our adjustment and check the gap positioning on the front side of the machine. And so I'm using the spur gear here to make the adjustment on this side. The spur gear is disconnected, and I'm only rotating the position of this side of the roller, and I'm using the bar up here to control the other side. And so what I'm trying to achieve here is a perfect sliver of light on far left and right of the machine, making sure it's balanced and perfect. I should have the same gap over here as I have on that side of the machine. And so it's making adjustments to the left side as well as the right side and having those two perfectly balanced. Once I think I'm close, I go ahead and engage that spur gear and then give both sides a rotation by controlling this side of the adjustment, raise it up, raise it down, and then rotate my roller top and bottom to make sure they stay in alignment regardless of the positions of my rollers. If your machine's an older model and you've used it a lot for mounting substrates, you'll notice the gap has developed kind of a cone area to it. So check your roller in a couple different locations to make sure you really are perfectly parallel with that roller. Mine's looking really good. So now at this point, I want to go ahead and lock down this spur gear mechanism. The big key here, though, is not to over-tighten this screw on the front. You want your spur gear engaged, but not too much pressure. Just a little bit more than hand tight. You should have a little bit of wiggle room, just enough so where that spur gear cannot pop off of those teeth. We'll tighten it with the 5mm, just a little bit beyond hand tight, but enough to where it can still move. Little wiggle room there. And then we're going to rotate that set screw into position so we can tighten that down. Double check to make sure you're not having too much tension on there. That needs to be able to move for the laminator to properly function and not bind The way to test if you have it tight is it should be able to take a full rotation without any resistance. I actually have a little resistance in mind, so I'm going to loosen that set screw up, back the spur gear out just a little bit, and then tighten it again. And now I can do a full rotation with my hand, and that's able to rotate with no resistance on there, running nice and smooth. So I know I'm in a good position on the spur gear setting. One last check before I button everything up. Make sure we're still nice and parallel. Nice small gap. Small, even gap all the way across the left and the right extremes of my pinch wheels. It looks great. So let's go ahead and put the panel back in place. And now we're gonna go ahead and put all of our tension knobs back in place, align the set screw up with the flat part of the bar, and then tighten that set screw down. Now that I have my pinch wheels aligned, there's no reason why I can't run entire rolls of lamination straight and true and have the lam and the print film line up all the way through and never develop wrinkles. So for those stuck around long enough, I promised you two little tricks to work with your laminator. And so here's a quick, easy way to keep your laminator rolls nice and clean so you're not developing little dust flakes or particles that might get stuck in there from laminating on boards. So I'm taking a piece of remnant of scrap self-adhesive that I had laying around here, and I'm exposing the self-adhesive all the way through, and then I'm going to fix that to my grit roller, my pinch roller on the bottom here. You can see my top pinch roller is nice and clean already. The bottom one hasn't been clean in a while. I'm going to start the lamination process and expose that self-adhesive. Now the trick here is grabbing it before it sticks to itself, and that's starting to come around. Go ahead and remove that. And this is a lot like those nose strips for pulling out blackheads. You're going to pull out all the invisible particles that get embedded into the silicone roller here and get it nice and clean. And as it's finishing its rotation, I'm removing the part that's already been stuck, pulling that away. All right, that pulled out a whole bunch of things out of my rollers, just dust, debris, little flecks of PVC, maybe some max metal, whatever I was using this thing to mount on. And it's going to have it nice and clean. Okay, great. The next trick I wanted to show you is very useful anytime you're dealing with lamination or self-adhesive vinyl. Sometimes it's difficult to get that corner started, to get things either strung up through your laminate or you're mounting onto a board, to just get that starter strip to separate your lamination from your print film. You know, you get in there with your fingernails, sometimes it can leave a curled edge or kind of mess up the one little corner. And so what I like to do is I use a couple pieces of masking tape, and I apply one to the print film and one to the lamination film, and then use that as a handle to kind of pull those two pieces apart nice and clean, not having to wrinkle my corner. Working with synthetic liners sometimes too, really thin synthetic liners with a lamination or a print film can be real challenging separating those two. And using a couple pieces of masking tape to create handles on your film makes it so much easier to work with. I hope you found some of this instruction helpful, and stay tuned to our channel for other helpful tips on how to use your equipment in the most efficient way. Thanks for watching.